Okay, this video is supposed to analyze good classic technique and point out for you the important key factors that are special for very good diagonal stride. First, we look at the skier in ordinary speed. You can look into the rhythm, how he uses the body actively into the technique. Then we can look into it in slow motion. This brings another perspective. It's easier to notice things when you look at it in slow motion. And first of all, the important part is to grip the snow. In classic diagonal stride, you need to grip the snow. If not, you get slippery skis. And notice the first thing is how the skier are gliding onto the snow. And you see here that the skier has distributed pressure on both heel and forefoot, and you are in a balance position. And you also can see, if you put a line onto this, you will see that the weight of the skier is distributed forward and behind this line. And you also see when it continues, the hip goes forward and comes even closer to this line. And you see how high position the hip are, and also the whole body. And you see how the skiers from this position lower the body weight onto the pool, so you get more force in the pools. You see here now, upper body goes down together with the knee that also lowers the foot. So this is a cooperation between upper body and legs. Upper body goes down, leg goes down. And this brings the skier into the position where the kick starts. And this is important because if the skiers are not rising from this position, you get a late kick. And late kick brings also slippery skis. So from here, the skier are supposed to go through this line. And you will see he goes up at once. And if he will lower himself even more from this, you see, from this position, you see, you go down, and this is the lowest position. And if it continues going down here throughout the kick, then we have a late kick, and that's not good. When you see that this is not only that you are going down in the legs to grip the snow, you also lower the upper body together with it, and that gives it a little down movement in the upper body, a little down movement in the legs, so it don't becomes too much, because we don't want too much up and down movement. So if it's only done in the legs, it's often too less, and it becomes too heavy for the skiers, for the legs to cope with this. So it's important that both legs and feet are doing this coordinated. Another part of this part, technical solution, is that when the upper body is going on to the pool, you are using your stomach to bring more force into the pool. And you see that the back are like a curved shape, like this. That means that the stomach muscles has made force onto the pool. And this stretches out the muscles in the back, and it stretches out the muscles in the seat, and it also makes the whole body ready for the kick. So the kick starts actually in the back muscles, the seat muscles, in the leg muscles, and finally in the lower leg muscles. So it's like a whole body that are doing the stroke, and it's also a whole body that's doing the arms stroke. It's not only the arms and the feet are doing this, it's the body work that is important. So into this position, you see how the body now is like in a compression. Every muscle is ready to start the kick, and it's a kick throughout the whole body. And when you're finished with the kick, you see that you have a line from the toe and until the upper body, and you see that you have a very good forward pulsation out of this. You have one part that keeps the body up, but you also have one part that brings the body forward. And these two must be also coordinated, so it's not too much that goes up and not too much going forward. It must be an balance between the direction, and you can control this by putting on the line from the toe to the ears, and then you see that there's a line. Okay, then the kick brings you in this direction, a little bit up, a little bit forward, or a lot forward if you like. There's also another important part that I will mention for you that is like a prerequisite for doing this rhythm with the upper body. And you see here that he puts the elbow forward, and he almost puts the arm on the elbow into the pool. And this makes it's a very good position if you want to put body force on the pool. If the arms becomes too stretched, out like this, I can make it like this, then you get a very weak arm. But when you put up it like into almost 90 degrees, you get a strong arm, and you get momentum for the upper body on the pool. So this is an important prerequisite for doing this a very good body movement and the rhythm in the body. Once more, high hip, go down into compression by lowering upper body and feet equally. And you can look at the next next position here. You see that when the kick starts, the angle of the legs and the angle of the upper body is almost the same. I would prefer that this upper body angle a little bit sharper than the leg, but very often it's opposite. And then if it's opposite, you get a lot of force going in that direction, but for this person, the force will bring him this direction, because the upper body is lower than a sharper angle than the legs. So the prerequisite is putting up your elbow, seek with the elbow into the pool, and use the upper body on the pool by using the stomach, using the back muscles to support the stroke. Then you get long cycle length, you get long strides, and that's a very effective way to go a diagonal stride.